Hello, in this video I'm going to be talking about cell division. So here the first one is about how our cells get to divide. And it is composed, first we have the interphase stage right here, which is all this. It is composed of G1, S, and G2. So in here, G1 is in charge. Here's where the cell is doing its normal like functions, which is like generating cellular energy, maintaining homeostasis, just a regular work that it always does. Then in here we are gonna have one checkpoint in G1. This checkpoint, to pass the checkpoint to the S phase, the cellular environment has to be the adequate to pass and to support the DNA synthesis. Then after it moves to the S phase, here is where the DNA is replicated and to form the new form the new sister chromatids and identical chromosomes. And then once it's done with replication of the DNA, it moves to the G2 phase. In here, this stage, the cell is preparing for mitosis, which is this part right here. And then we have the telophase. I'm sorry, starting with the prophase, prometaphase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase, and cytokinesis. So here in G2, it is the replication of organelles like chloroplast, mitochondria, and also the endomembrane system. And in here we have another checkpoint to make sure that the cell is going to be able to go to mitosis and divide and be a healthy cell. If it doesn't pass this checkpoint, the cell will die. So now, if it does pass the checkpoint, it goes to mitosis, which includes all these phases right here that I'm going to explain. So starting with prophase, here the nuclear envelope disappears, and we see the centrioles on both sides right here of the cell, and also the mitotic spindles form, which are these lines right here. Then we move to prometaphase. Here are the mitotic spindles attached to the chromosomes, and they start moving towards the middle of the cell. And here then we have metaphase, and here we see the chromosomes already in the center of the cell. And here we also see that two kinetochore spindles will be attached to each chromosome, to the center of each chromosome, so that when we move to anaphase, the chromosomes will separate and will move towards both ends of the cell. Here in anaphase we have another checkpoint. If the chromosomes are not attached correctly to the kinetochore spindles, the cell will die and it will not move towards telophase and cytokinesis. And then we are here in the final stage. Here we have telophase, where the chromosomes separate and we start seeing the cell membrane around the two cells. And then we have, at the end, we have cytokinesis. And here we have the separation of the cytoplasm. And in eukaryotes, we're gonna see a cell plate formed right here until both cells separate. And in animals, we don't see a cell plate because they're gonna have a cell wall, not a cell membrane. So in the animal cells, we're gonna see a cleavage furrow right here. And yeah, after this, the cell divides in two and then continues its work. Then the last thing I want to talk about is about meiosis, which is a production of haploid cells which mature into the gametes. And after fertilization, which is the the fusion of haploid sperm and haploid egg, we have a diploid zygote. So we have two rounds. We have meiosis one and we have meiosis two. In meiosis one, we have all this. Here we have homologous chromosomes together, and then they move towards the middle of the cell. And in prophase one, right here, we have the crossover of homologous chromosomes, and they gather at synapses. Then they move towards the middle. Then they separate right here in anaphase. And then we have these two cells right here. After that, we have meiosis two, where we have the separation of the sister chromatids. Here, we don't have an S phase. And at the end, we're gonna see the homologous chromosome separating. I mean, the sister chromatids forming the four haploid daughter cells.